All right, we're back with another match against Michael Hetrick, Ship at Hawa. He's rocking the Living End, and we're rocking what I've been calling the Modern Art deck, Modern Artifacts. And we got a pretty decent hand here. I prefer to wait on Thoughtseize, but since we don't have a Dimir Signet and we're on the draw, we kind of need to pull the trigger now. Shriek Maw does nothing. Beast Within actually does nothing because we have a Spell Sky. So I'm going to take his Jungle Weaver, keep him off drawing cards. I'd rather he has Beast Within in hand than a random card, honestly. Like, since we did draw the Spell Sky, it just doesn't seem like it really does anything. I mean, it will maybe do something later in the game. But if we're able to keep him from drawing a Violent Outburst or a Demonic Dread. Hang on, I'm going to turn off my heater. So again, if you notice that makes a noticeable impact in sound performance, let me know, because I want to improve the quality of my videos. And I wouldn't be surprised if that background static was confusing, or confused the, I don't know, the microphone or whatever. Anyways, pretty interesting match so far. Not sure I really like it from this side. I was gonna say my record, but I don't know the order that we're posting it in. But games are certainly interesting. They go long. I feel like I haven't really played all that well, necessarily. There's been a lot of options, though. Okay, our Signet gets Beast Within. I guess the plan on that was to prevent us. Maybe we should have played the Blink Moth so we'd get in. I guess the plan for that was to keep us off of playing Tezzeret this turn. Oops. Missed 3 damage. Oops. Oh well. Click through that. Well, we'll see if this game comes down to 3 damage. It may not. The Blink Moth being in play would have been nice. Well, I guess we could Greaves up the Blink Moth if we need to. Take Demonic Dread. This game might come down to... This game might come down to damage. So, it would definitely be a feel bad. So Greaves being on the Beast means that a Demonic Dread is ineffective as it has no targets. Also, Shriek Maw cannot target our Beast. So, I still stand by that. Yeah, I mean, the Beast Within could have honestly won us the game, as we had no pressure in hand, and Michael had no way of knowing that. I mean, I think that he was not incorrect, as he also had a Demonic Dread and a Shriek Maw. Didn't know we would have the Greaves. Okay. A Fulminator Mage. Definitely an annoying one. Buys him time. I guess make him use it. There's not really a reason to not, as far as I can see. So I'm gonna, if we get within 3 life, we both messed up. You could have equipped Nexus. Oh. And so I've missed 6 damage. Have I missed 6 damage then? Like, could have equipped the Nexus. Can we pretend that you're at 6? Jeez, is all I have to say. Missed 6 damage. Well, this game might not come down to damage. It's unclear. We'll see. Mox Opal. We could send with the Beast, but that's not the best play. I'm not hugely in love with it, as we don't really want Shriekmaw to even be in his graveyard. So this is one of the inconsistencies of the deck. It really does want to draw a Tezzeret Well, if we had traded, he couldn't Demonic Dread, I guess. Oh, looks like Demonic Dread's gonna happen. Okay. Nope. Another big blocker. Okay, big body. I guess we want to get Spellskite down. I guess I should have already got it down. So yeah, this is one of the inconsistencies of this deck. And I will actually... Do I want to grieve the Spellskite? No, because we might draw a Forge Master next turn. Yeah, one of the ways this deck is inconsistent is... It really does, like, kind of need to draw... Okay, attack with both, interesting. It really kind of does need to draw a Forge Master or a Tezzeret at some point to actually win most of the time. We could draw one of our Worm Coils. Michael's got, interesting, one card left. I wonder what that is. So I missed 6 damage, which is obviously relevant, but... Well, there's the Outburst. And we're probably just gonna die. So it doesn't look like the damage is actually relevant. 5, 6, 7, 8. No, yeah, he's not gonna kill us yet. So we can, we're still gonna have a turn to rip. I could have held the second Spellskite as well, which would have not really saved us much. Okay, well, Blink Moth Nexus is not gonna be the savior. If we had Spellskite, we'll see if he attacks with everybody. Okay, we're dead. Looks like the 6 damage is irrelevant. Well, I mean, we went 16 cards without drawing a Tezzeret or an Angel or a Construct or a Forge Master or whatever. That happens sometimes. We saw a game where Michael went like a long time without drawing a Living End, so welcome to Magic the Gathering, huh? I'm okay with that. Alright, so we've decided we want these. And I've been cutting the Transmuter, which is a bit risky. I've also been cutting the Mind Slaver for more Worm Coils, and I've been cutting the Spellskites as they've been kind of meh. The Damnation has not come up yet. I've also been considering Fulminator Mage. Michael showed us Kessig Wolf Run earlier, and it's obviously decent with the Living End, so I'm going to try out a Fulminator Mage over the last Spellskite this time around. It seems fine, especially on the play.